let me bring you on a tour around the animal kingdom. Today, we will discover the animal kingdom's 6 basic classifications. These 6 classifications have their own defined characteristics. Some are similar to others, while some are unique. Let us first look at mammals. The mammals. Most mammals have hair as body covering. It keeps them warm in cold places. They are warm-blooded and they use their lungs to breathe. They give birth to live young, but some mammals, like the platypus, lay eggs. The easiest way to identify a mammal is how it feeds its young with milk through the mammary glands. Some mammals live on land, just like us humans and cows. There are also those that thrive in water, like whales. But do you know what's more awesome? There are mammals who are capable of living on both. Let us now move on to insects. Insects have hard outer shell called exoskeleton, which they use for protection and support. They are cold-blooded. They reproduce by laying eggs, and they breathe through multiple breathing holes in their body. Some insects live on land, some in water, and some on both. To identify an insect, pay close attention to their legs. They have 6 of them. They also have 3 major body parts, and some of them grow wings. Some of the insects you can see around you are grasshoppers and butterflies. Aren't they beautiful? What is another group of animals that grows wings too? Yes, the birds. We know that birds have feathers, but did you know that they do not only use it for flying? It also keeps them warm and dry. Just like the mammals, they are warm-blooded. They reproduce by laying eggs, and they breathe through their lungs. They live on land, usually building nests on trees. All birds have a beak, 2 legs, and a pair of wings. But this doesn't mean that all of them can fly. The most popular flightless birds are penguins. Aren't they so cute? Examples of animals that belong to the bird kingdom are ducks and chickens. Let us now move on to the next group of animals. Which group of animals move only by swimming? Yes, the fish. Fish are covered with scales that help them swim and protect them from threats. Fish are cold-blooded. They reproduce by laying hundreds of eggs, but some fish give birth to live young, like guppies. They breathe through their gills, taking in dissolved oxygen from the water. Because they cannot survive being on land, fish build their homes underwater. Fish can be as small as your goldfish or as large as the shark. What is the next group of animals? Let me give you a hint. It starts with an A. Yes, amphibians. Amphibians are covered with moist skin, and they are cold-blooded. They reproduce by laying eggs, and they have several breeding methods. Usually, young amphibians have gills. When they grow older and start living on land, they begin using their lungs that have formed. Some amphibians also use their skin for breathing. In fact, some of them don't even have lungs at all. Although amphibians are capable of surviving both land and water, many of them spend their adult life on land. What are some examples of amphibians? We have frogs and salamanders. Now, the last group of animals, the reptiles. Reptiles have dry, thick skin covered with hard scales which serve as protection. Reptiles are cold-blooded. They reproduce by laying eggs, and they breathe using their lungs. They are able to live on land or in water. Some of the coolest reptiles out there are chameleons and crocodiles. And that's the basic classification of animals. There are so much more to learn about this topic, but that's for another day. See See you next time, kids. Bye.
Thank you for watching our video. If you like our video, please give us a thumbs up and leave a comment in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe and click here for more videos. See you next time!